All right, here we are today's adventure. We're going from Johnson's Ferry all the way down past Powers Ferry to Pace's Mill.
You know, we're going to go for bass, so we're going to try this little lizard guy. I know the least about bass fishing. Every now and then I get lucky and score one. Look at that. Look at this guy. I think it's a big red-eyed bass. He's huge.
Here's the NOC location. Yeah. And it's a gorgeous day today. It's going to be about low 80s, low humidity. Here's the boat launch. Water clean and green. Perfect. So we'll get back to you in a second. Second dip. Back in the wind. Get our boats in the water. We'll be good to go. Beautiful day on the river, Johnson's Ferry. We got lean, clean, and green today, which is perfect. About 83 degrees. And I mean, it's gorgeous. It should be good fishing if we only knew how to fish, right, Psychic Joe? But we'll see. No excuses today, let's put it that way. If we don't catch fish, we just don't know how to fish for bass. But we're at mile marker 310.5. Johnson's Ferry, and our voyage today will take us 4 miles down to Powers Island and then another 3 miles to Pace's Mill boat launch with all kinds of little adventures along the way, including Cochran Shoals, which is right before the Powers Island area, and also we'll go under 285, and then we have the Doubles Racecourse Shoals, which are always an adventure, and then we'll have the Jumping Rock area, which is always fun, then some more shoals, the dog park, we go under the 75 highway bridge, and then we're at Pace's Mill boat launch. Full day adventure. There's the Alpharetta Outfitters. Shout out to the Alpharetta Outfitters. Situated. So just sit back and enjoy the ride today. See the moon straight ahead. I don't know if you can see it on camera, but it's about 2/3. Hey Joe, check out the moon. That's pretty cool. It's 11:11 a.m. and we got the moon up there. How about that? Pretty wild. So today we're gonna try a couple different things. You know, we're gonna go for bass, so we're gonna try this little lizard guy. These are called paddle tail. I know the least about bass fishing. So if you see my videos, this section of the Hooch or the Etowah or the Chesity,
Every now and then I get lucky and score one, but again, I'm mostly trout. But who knows? Apparently they like, this is the best water we've had for sure. This is lean, clean, and green. So we're gonna try hitting these places, that, you know, we'll see. like, why not troll and just see? And holy cow, he jumped on it. Huge. Panic on the boat. Yes, I should probably. Wasn't even prepared to catch it. Three-legged blue lizard with a green squiggly tail. He's a champion, though. It's the first big bass I've ever caught out here on the Chattahoochee. Again, we're in the lower section, and this is bass section. I mean, they're supposed to be here. I just haven't ever figured out how to do it. Today, he was just trolling, decided, what the heck, just throw it back there and let it troll. We got a nice little current. I can't wait to watch this video along with you guys, because I don't even know what I was saying. I was so excited. Total chaos. Watch this just to see what I was doing. That's like hitting a home run in baseball, man. That's a lot of excitement going on. I'm trying to get it in the boat. I mean, trying to get a little video of it. You gotta do that. Because just like in big wave surfing, if you don't have it on video, it doesn't count. Thank you.
lot of arm strength from casting all the time.
See that? A huge one right here just surfaced. Yeah.
Soap Creek. Unfortunately, we have the leaf blowers going. But as everyone knows from my videos, when we hit this place, Soap Creek, the mouth of Soap Creek, there's a levee up here. This is where gar are known to hang out. Lots of gar. Some huge gar. I'm expecting to see some in just a minute. They usually hang out right at the mouth. So if you look ahead in the waters below you, look carefully, you'll see some. Let's see if they're here today. See them yet? Nothing yet. That's really surprising. They'd ordinarily be right about here. Let's see if they're in the shadows. It's super low today, so. It's interesting. Well, it may be because it's so low, but. We'll see. Yeah, I don't see them. So they must have, somewhere else today. But if you guys check out my other videos on, I have another video on Soap Creek. You should check it out because in that video, it was so cool. Is what you're looking at right now, this levee, we went over that in our kayaks. The water was about 6 inches over that levee. So go check out my Soap Creek video in the Chattahoochee playlist. And you'll see, like, I'm coming up right here, we went over it, and you can go about a mile up that river, up that creek, Soap Creek. You can get into a golf club. There's a waterfall up there. That video is really awesome. I'm catching bass and sunfish back there. And that's Collins Drive right in front of us there. But yeah, when you see this, when the water's higher and you get over that levee, it's a really fun trip.
Now when it's low like this, we've caught some pretty good sized bass back in here. In fact, usually on this section of the river, this is like the only area that I have ever actually catch something, is right in here. Throw Mr. Blue over the levee and then draw him back. It's right on the other side of this, bass like to hang out as well. Sidekick Joe does not have Tourette's syndrome. He's listening to the Georgia Tech Notre Dame game in Dublin, Maryland. So if you hear occasional yells, lovely townhomes. Goes down to Powers Ferry, so that's mile marker 308.
So the down hunt had ended. The beginning here is just some beautiful trails and mountain bike trails, jogging trails. A very fun place. If you haven't checked it out, you need to. It's a lot of fun. And we have parking lots on this side and on Powers, down by Powers Ferry, 285. Heck of an office view though, if you had one of those facing this way. Pretty awesome. tip. Chaos! Got snagged, got tangled, then hit a rock. That's how quickly you can go from super calm to chaos. I don't know if I saved it or not. Listen to my own. That's got to be the only rock in this entire river that I could have hit. Oh, that's awesome. Alright, he died a hero. The Blue Angel. He died a hero. Chaos. Got snagged, which is hard to do with squishy. So his little hook must have come out. And right when I got snagged, I got back into a rock. That's nuts. We're approaching Cochran Shoals. Always beautiful. Champion Blue Angel. I got something else on here, but who knows? Joe's got the perfect lure. He's got the squishy crawfish, which is really probably the perfect thing to fish with out here today. Although my guy went for the bass, went for the blue one. So you can navigate these shoals any way you want. They're basically shelves dropping all the way down to the 285. Drop down one level right there, and it's low like this, so you really got to navigate all the rocks. Stump right here. Did you hear me? There's a big stump. Okay, I'll get out of your way.
Can I borrow your sunscreen? That was fun. It's been a while since we've been to the Shoals when they were, we don't usually stick around. We usually just cruise right through. It's fun in there. You know, it reminds me of, it's very similar to the rock garden down on, you know, but we never play around in there. So that was fun just kind of paddling around inside, just like the rock garden. It's about the same thing. Rock garden on the Etowah, lower Etowah, below Lake Altoona. You guys want to see that? It's pretty cool. Put in it. Look at my U Harley movie. U Harley to, Kingston, and it's got the rock garden, which is just like this, very similar to Cochran Shoals. All right, probably should put sunscreen on at the beginning of the trip. There you go, nice catch. Looks like there's a fair amount of people putting in down there. At the NOC, we shall see. On the right here, that's the end of the park that started back there on Collins Drive. I can't remember how long it is. I'm thinking it's a mile and a half or so. And this is Powers Island right here. And the NOC location is right down there before the bridge. Let's see. And I think we have a lot of tubers. And then all those people, they feed down to the jumping rock area, which is always fun. a stump. Went in.
Thank you.
right, let's do this. Devil's race course, here we come. That's a beautiful bamboo jungle over there. Great hiking. And straight ahead is the main course of Devil's Racecourse. All of these shoals are called Devil's Racecourse shoals, but that right in front of us is the main section. When it's low, you got some big rapids. What do you think, Joe? Like a class one or class, maybe approaching class two?
Approaching class two.
Yeah, so it's like a one plus. It's a one plus. Yeah, it's a one plus. But at this level, it's the best right now. So buckle up. Refreshing. This is the rock you gotta watch out for right here on the left. See how you can just barely see the little side? Right there, that little side piece. That's what gets people every time. Joe got eddied.
I did.
He got eddied right into the rock. Shoal bass earlier?
Yep. Nice.
Yeah.
Good luck, man.
Thanks. No fishing really down here. It's more up above. Man. Yeah. We put it at Johnson's Ferry. It's fun. Yeah, for one of us. Yeah, I'm pretty tired. Oh! guys have your life jacket, life preservers? Because they bust you up. I mean, even if you're in a tube, you gotta have a life jacket.
I had two.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Huh, look at that. That is a nice striper. Look at that thing. Yeah. What are you guys throwing at him? What are you throwing at him? Yeah? Very nice.
All right, all right.
4 kg!
Oh, yeah. What up, yo?
Let's go!
Alright.
So these shoals are called Long Island Shoals for some reason. And these aren't very treacherous. Just follow the bank along the right. But they're fun and they're pretty long. How is this place?
You gotta keep going.
Mm-hmm.
That's fun. I love that. Hammock spot over there. I saw a psychic Joe eyeballing his. Look at that hammock spot. He loves to do his hammock spots, and that's a good one right there. Right on the point. That's beautiful. I love that spot. A gorgeous day. I mean, like a perfect day. So if it's 83 degrees and 40% humidity on the river, it's probably more like 75 degrees, 78 degrees. And it's glorious. Dog park is packed. Look at that. How's the fishing, Joe? What'd you get again? A bass?
A bass.
Like a little spotted bass? This is like one of 100 days that I get to actually brag a little bit. Although I am quite the big game hunter, as you know, I don't have a lot of bass, but I have some big ones. I mean, we're talking less than five. But when I get one, just saying. Not the quantity, it's the quality.
It was a quality bass.
It really was, and the more I learned about it, I'm more excited about it. But that's also the exact same bass that I pulled out of Lake Tugaloo in that cove.
And
that was a red-eye bass, absolutely. And that one was that was smaller than this one.
Really?
Oh yeah, no, this one, I'm telling you, this one's definitely bigger. Of course, I'm not gonna say otherwise, but that's just part of fishing math. Joe and I are definitely not the bass fishermen. I mean, if you're on this channel to pick up fishing tips on bass, I love you, but you probably need to go over to Hydriac or a few of the other great channels that are out there that are awesome. What's the guy on the Etowah River that's so good? Yeah, I apologize, but it's like Benitez. You're gonna have to look it up. Sammy Benitez? Look him up on Etowah River floats. He is an animal. I've watched his videos, and he's an animal. He catches more bass than I've ever seen. He even makes his own lures sometimes, which is nuts. So check him out. Hydriac, one of my all-time favorites. He's good at everything. But he's great at fishing. But especially for bass. Now, you want to catch trout? Come to us. Red Kayak Guy and Psychic Joe, we know how to catch trout. In this section, primarily in where there's rapids and there's shoals, and we're very good at that. We're going straight through. Sounds good to me. That's all right. We're good. We're probably at the 1 mile marker to the Paces Mill boat launch. I haven't seen a mile marker in a while. Oh, I think there's one coming up here at the dog park. So right ahead, straight ahead there, that's the infamous dog park. I think it's called WHITEWATER Park. Look it up, but you can hear the dogs. It's a legal place to bring your dogs, take them off the leash, let them run around, which is pretty cool. And everybody hangs out there. A lot of people on tubes and, you know, new people on the river think that's the takeout. It's not. So don't get stuck with that. We're about a mile away from the takeout. But that is an awesome place. If you have a dog and you want to bring it down to the river, that's the place to do it. Let him out. Let him play with his friends. It's a great spot. And a lot of times we come down this river, we hang out on that big rock out there in the middle, just chill. You get some very late sun here because of the way the land is. So, awesome spot. Today we're going to cruise on down. Okay, there's a mile marker. Mile marker 304.5, just before the I-75 highway bridge. And when you get out at Pace's Mill, boat launch, you'll be on your exit will be onto 41. And 41 is in the Cumberland Mall area, Acres Mill. What's up, guys?
Hello.
All right.
You guys catch anything today?
Other than, how about a cool buzz?
Yeah, we did catch that.
Okay, nice. Job well done. This guy looks like an important NOC employee. Yep. How's it going? You're an important employee for the NOC, I can tell.
Try to be.
Somebody's got to do it, man.
Yes, sir.
You guys do a great job. We love the NOC.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
All right, man. right, and here's the Paces Mill boat launch. We made it, 7 mile journey. What an adventure, what a great float. Do it however you want, but it's awesome. Tubes, kayak, whatever. I recommend it for everybody, it's awesome. You can put in from Powers Island, it's a 3 mile float. Johnson's Ferry is 7 mile. It's always tricky because it's super shallow here. You just gotta read the pebble beach. We're gonna run out of water soon.
Thank you for watching.